We don't believe in the next amendment again!
We can get you there. We can get you there even better. Because sometimes when people are doing this and doing that, they damage their muscles. A lot of people don't know about the muscle. If you keep on working out, doing stuff, curling wrong, of course your arms gonna get big. But you gotta know everything about the muscle of doing it. So I need you to be coachable. You have to know about the muscle. You understand me?
Yes, sir.
So you gotta be coachable. Coach on the football field, coach at home. Your dad trying to show you how to build your little birdhouse or whatever you want, the doghouse. And you're not listening, but if you listen, you end up learning how to build it. You gotta be coachable all the way around. Just like pastors coach you read the Bible or knowing about Jesus. You gotta listen. So you can know more about Jesus, get closer to Jesus.
Hey, so tell everybody your name.
Cameron Showers.
Cameron Showers. What made you want to come to 8th Ray? What made you want to be a part of this family?
Well, I just wanted to get better, you know, and focus on my skills, get better at the game of basketball.
If y'all don't know, his dad was with the Rand State basketball team. Won the Nationals, whatever it was, state basketball. He was a great athlete by the name of Floyd Showers. So by you coming to 8th Ray, what you think it helped you with?
Mainly my footwork and then working on my strength and my arms and getting me faster. So, along those lines.
Okay. I would say you probably been here for how many workouts?
Like 6, 7.
About 6 or 7? 6 or 7? Yeah. So you've been here for 6 or 7 workouts. You've seen a lot of progress within how many days?
I would say on like the 3rd day I saw progress.
I say the 3rd workout, like you said, feet became quick. And I'm not just saying this to promote this, but his feet became real agile. He's very quick. He loves coming here. He ain't even act like the camera wasn't here. He worked hard. He's a very humble kid. Valley Christian standout. Oh, he will be. So he came here to get prepared for next year for basketball. Man, it's good to have humble kids like yourself here. My daughter go to Valley Christian, and you could tell them Valley Christian kids, man, their attitudes, man. It's like they all the same. Very humble kids, man. And glad to have this young man here, and I can't wait to finish working with him. And then we'll come back hopefully later on in maybe 6 months or 4 months down the road, and you'll see you'll probably see his different build that he might have. He might have a different stature because that's what we do at 8th Ray. You know, people get their statures built within like 10 to 12 workouts. So once again, man, I'm glad to have you a part of this thing, man.
Happy to be here.
Boom, here we go. Good grab, my grab. Cross, when I say roll, fall, get up. Remember, roll. Oh, he's gonna flip. Boom, here we go. Go, roll. Get up. Oh, yeah.
All right, Ralph, good job.
Roll. Get up. Here we go. Oh, go. Roll. Get up. Good job. Go. Roll. Boom. Oh, good grab. See, I want to make it hard like that. Go. Bro. Get up. Good grab, Jay. Great work, Jay. Go. Bro. Get up. There you go. There you go. Woo! Good grab. Go. Bro. Get up. Get up. Get up.
Get up.
Good job. Hands. Go. Get the hands up. Go. Hands. Come on.
Let's go.
There you go. What's the G for?
God.
The F for?
Family.
S.
School.
S.
Sports.
I want you to be what?
Humble.
And not a what?
Rather.
Two black.
So, Coach Pat, how do you feel about Coach Merrill?
He's a great guy. He has an awesome vision. He's a great trainer. He's helped a lot of young kids, and that's why I wanted to come and be a part of what he was doing.
Okay, so another question. So how do you feel about the kids in this program?
We got a lot of hard workers. We got a lot of future stars. The kids love it. They come get a taste of what we're doing, and it's just great. It's just great giving back. game that I love, I'm able to pass down to you, my nephew, my son, my son's friend, and my other nephew, which isn't here today.
So do you feel like you're seeing results since you've been here?
Definitely. I see more hunger in you. I see more hunger in Patrick, Ralphie, Micah. I see all the kids. All the kids are progressing. They're progressing great. And they all really feed into what we're teaching.
So what is your end goal with this whole thing?
End goal is to see every young man that comes here go to college, get a scholarship, whether they play professional or not, become successful in life.
Hey, you heard it best from Coach Pat.
What's our motto? We don't believe in sin, the best we what?
Living the game!
You had that attitude, man. You go far, far, far. Here you go. Oh, there we go. That hand. Yep.
Just like that.
Just like that. I bet you can't run it. I bet you can't run it. Ready? Here we go. Ready? Go run it now.
But you are there.
Ready? Go. Here you go.
Yes.
There you go. You
yeah,
got it.
You is.
Now you got it. Now you got it. All right. Good job. Good job. Go. That hand. Boom. This hand over here. There you go, little man. There you go, little man. Way to work. Ooh. Back there. Way to work. Keep back work. There, little man. Way to work. Way to work. Good feet. Good feet. Good feet. Good feet. Palms up. You're a basketball player. Palms up. Come on. Good work.
I'm Coach Pat. We're here with my nephew, Braylon Dyson. Braylon, what brought you to A4A?
What brought me to A4A was I wanted to be better, and I feel like once you explained it to me, what we were doing, like I felt like home already. Like my first day here felt like home already. So I knew once I came here, I was ready to work, ready to put my head down and get to it.
Your mom had inboxed me a couple days after you started, and she told me that you were hungry and that you were more focused and that this is what you really wanted. How did Coach Ray influence you?
He influenced me by like all like the mottos and everything he was saying to me. Like he wanted the best for me, and I could see that. He was pushing me every day to do the best and make sure I was doing the right things and making sure like everything I did it at my max capacity.
And where do you see yourself once you're done with training and training starts with your team next summer?
I see myself being 10 steps ahead of everybody else. And I can help my teammates bring that out of them. Because, like, you know, we feel everybody else. We feel around us. So if I'm going hard, they're going to want to go hard. And that's going to make us all better.
What do you think about your cousin Patrick?
Young guy. He's definitely got a lot of potential. I think if he puts his head down, you know, go a little harder and possibly go Division I.
And there you have it, my nephew Braylon Dyson.
Curtis Shaw Jr. I'm a 10th grade student at Austintown Fitch High School. I am a wide receiver and free safety. Today I'm at A4A Academy for Athletes. I've been coming here for about a month going on. It's a gym where you come. It's not only a gym, but it's also a leadership program where it teaches you young men to become growing adults in ways they can be better in life and in sports and in the classroom. This is definitely added to anything I do, especially in the classroom. Even though I've only been coming here for a short amount of time, my work ethic in sports and the classroom has definitely grown, And I'm a three-sport athlete, football, basketball, and track. So coming here in the off-season whenever outdoor track isn't in season or basketball definitely gets me ready for competition that I'll be up against. Well, in here, we're definitely brothers. You know, we're friends, close. But on the field, you know I have to play for my team. And there's not going to be any bad blood or anything, but I know I'm going to do what I have to do to win, and I hope they'll do the same. A for A, Academy for Athletes, and God is definitely a big part of everything I do. What's your name?
Cameron Shaw.
A little louder, please.
Cameron Shaw.
How old are you?
12.
What grade are you in?
Sixth.
What sports do you play?
Football and basketball.
Why do you come to A for A?
To get better and learn a little bit more about life.
Okay. Do you like coming here?
Yes.
Do you think Coach Morrow does a good job at what he does?
Yes.
What is one thing that you have taken from this place?
Leadership and how to be a better person.
Name?
Jaden McCaskill.
Age?
14.
In grade?
9th.
What school are you in?
Austin Tom Fitch.
How many sports do you participate in?
3.
What sports?
Football, track and field, and wrestling.
Nice. What's one thing you can take from Coach Morrow and A for A?
Just to work hard and, like, not be lazy.
You think Coach Morrow does a good job with all his teaching?
Yes.
How would you describe the, you know, the area of the people in A for A?
It's just hardworking and competitive. And no one is, like, sitting around. Everyone is always doing something.
What the? What? Man, y'all worked out hard today. Y'all worked out really hard. Who loves coming here, man? Raise your hand. Okay, you had fun here, didn't you?
Yeah.
So it's your first time? This ain't your first time. You've been here in summertime and all that. You've been here. You're my nephew. You've been here. This is how we say. Like, if the teacher say about who wanted to do the problem, raise your hand. You don't go like this. That's like you're unsure. Here. And you gotta be like this with aggressive eye. That's something I came up with, aggressive eye. Aggressive eye is in everything. Aggressive eye is in fighting. You gotta see those punches coming in, then you gotta see that open shot. Football, aggressive eye. Quarterback, he looking, oh, there you go. You get what I'm saying? On the problem, school, you do this in school. School, you like, okay, dang, what's the problem? Oh, there you go, your eyes get big. You understand where I'm going with this?
Yeah.
Running back. You know, back up. You cut, go through, boom. Oh, shoot, boom! Because I'm trying to keep this place open for y'all, man. Back in the days, we had all the centers. We had the Brooks Club, we had Oakland, we had the Hashram House, which they call it Settlement. He was over there. I was over there on the weekends because my grandmother stayed over there. We had the McGuffey Center, we had the Buckeye Elks, we had the Mill Creek Center.
We had the parks.
Everything.
You don't see nobody there now.
He's there for me. I need a supporter of people. This guy right here. So can I get a hand for him? You are your parent. So when you're in class, make your parents proud. Make them proud. Be that good student, that great student, that humble student. And your parents will get rewards. When they say, oh, I met your son the other day. Such a sweet young man. That's what I'm talking about. A4A, you know what we do, man? You know what we do? We put on our super cape, our Superman cape. We said, old lady out there, she's struggling with groceries. And, oh, man, we're going to throw our A4A thing on. We're going to help her. That's the type of kids that I raised up in here.
We're here with Patrick Thompson Jr., my son, and his friend Ralphie. What do you like about A4A?
I like to train, you know, hard work, you know, build my body up so I can be the greatest.
What brought you to A4A?
What brought me to A4A is, like, I wanted to be good, you know? I wanted to be the best football player.
What brought you, Ralphie?
I wanted to be willing to work and I want to get muscly. I want to be a good MLB player.
That's good. What do you think about Coach Ray?
I think that he's a good guy, you know, good coach and, like, you know, just a good person overall.
And you?
I think he's a good guy. He's a good coach. He's funny. I like him a lot.
All right. What do you think about Coach Pat?
I think that, you know, he's my dad. Funny, you know, he could cut good too for sure. You know, he's a great guy.
What do you think?
I think he's a good guy. He let me know about this program, and I think he's a good guy. He drives me here every day, and I thank him for that.
Do you think that coming to A4A was the right decision for you?
Yes.
Ralphie?
Yes, I think because I'm willing to work.
These are two good guys. Real good. They're willing. They're dedicated. They come every day to work. They train hard. And they want to be the best they can be.
So, hello. I'm DeAndre Richard. What's your name?
Jaden Lumsden.
How do you feel about your workout today?
Good.
What do GFSS stand for?
God, Family, Sports, and School.
So how do you feel about today's practice?
Today's practice was good. We all got to it. We worked as a team. We just need to work together more and get better at what we do.
What are you struggling in? What are you mainly focused on?
I want to get faster.
Not even stronger?
Yeah, stronger too.
So how do you feel as a team? One out of 10. How do you feel? How did this workout go today?
A 9.5.
It went great for me too.
But what position do you play?
Running back and quarterback. I mainly play anything you want me to. I do what the coach do. I do what the coach told me to do.
What do you want to do when you grow up?
Go to the NFL. Move my mom out Youngstown. Out of the bad parts of Youngstown.
What team would you like to get drafted to?
I say the Jets or the Lions to make them better.
But what if they don't take you there? What if any team chooses you? What would you do there?
I see how the contract going, then I'll go there. It don't matter.
What college would you like to go to?
I got a top 3, Michigan, LSU, and Alabama.
But what if other college offer you Ohio State, Oregon, or MSU?
I'm really looking for a full ride, something that scouts see in me, something that I'm good at, I start.
So what if they put you at second string? Would you like to be a second string, or would you like to be a starter?
I like to be a starter, but second string is good too, so I can overshine the starter and become first. I can become first.
And what's the saying that y'all have about the bench?
We don't believe sitting the bench. We live in the game.
Say that together.
We don't believe sitting in the bench, we live in the game. What do you like about Coach Morrow's work ethic and his facility, what he does with us?
His work ethic and his physicality rubs off on me. Whatever I do rubs in on him. So if I was to, say I was to get ran over in the game, it was going to be that boy ain't doing it right. Or they'd say something bad. But when I came here, he seen the best of me, and I started pushing myself to where he got it.
This is my brother. What's your name?
Joseph Lumsden.
I'm Jaden Lumsden. What'd you like to do when you grow up?
Be in the NFL.
What college would you like to go to?
Miami.
What NFL team would you like to be drafted by?
Saints.
What do you like about Coach Murrow's work ethic and what he does here with us?
He's making me better, stronger, faster, all the above.
What do you think about today's practice? How'd it go?
We worked hard and, yeah.
How do you think it's from 1 to 10?
10.
How could it be better, as a team effort?
It was good all around, but we can work better, get faster, yeah. What's your name?
Jaden Lumsden.
What would you like to do when you grow up?
I like to be in the NFL.
What college team do you want to go to?
I have top 5, Bama, Ohio State, Michigan, or Oregon.
What NFL team would you like to go to?
Any team that wants me.
How old are you?
13 years old.
What school do you go to?
Austintown Fitch High School.
What's your height?
6'1".
What's your grade point average?
I'm a 3.7 student.
All right, that's good. You like your teachers? Are they nice to you?
Yeah. I just got to pay attention more, stop playing around, because sometimes I mess around too much and I'm a class clown.
How do you think today went?
Today went great. I liked it. We worked as a team. Yeah, but we can work better as a team, like stop messing around too much.
How did you do as an individual?
I think I did like a 8.5. Could have been better.
I heard that like you started like with Raymond way before he started this gym here. So tell me a little bit about it.
Well, it was crazy because basically he contacted me on Facebook and you said that you're a Facebook OG.
Yes, I'm a Facebook OG. Listen, starting in 2004, 2005.
Right, and I'm definitely a Facebook OG. So that's where he contacted me at, Facebook, and he said, hey man, I want you to come over and I want you to look at this spot. I'm planning on doing some things for the young people in Youngstown, Ohio. You know, I want to have a fitness center for all, you know, family members, husband, okay, wife, mother, father, brother, sister. And he was showing me his vision, and, you know, I could see it, but I couldn't really comprehend it.
Okay.
So to be standing here years later and everything that he showed me that he wanted to do is actually in existence.
Right, came into fruition.
Exactly. Yeah. And it's like, wow. And it just showed me personally as a photographer and a videographer that you have to have a vision and you have to have a plan. And then you have to execute it.
Execute it, and you got to have that grit, too.
Exactly.
Yes.
And that's exactly what he did. And, you know, I'm proud of him. I used to go see him play. I seen him win championship games, you know. So he's always been a tough gridiron quarterback. He's been the best. You know, I seen him play on different levels, semi-pro, and the young people love him. You know what I'm saying? And
I can tell.
He's doing a fantastic job.
Yes, especially with the kids here in the inner city. It's nothing but best for Youngstown.
Exactly. So I'm just glad to be a part of it. I hope you guys enjoy the video. Tell everyone your name.
I'm Brittany Nicole Averhart, straight from the north side of Youngstown. And actually, this is going to be my first day training with Raymond, so I'm looking forward to it.
Okay, great job. And thanks for the interview.
Yes, thank you.